Every planet is a living being and has an energy grid of electromagnetic energy in the biosphere. This electromagnetic field is the nervous system of the planet. Everything and everybody on this planet is energetically connected to this field, and therefore everything has an impact on everything. All thoughts and feelings from all Earth humans are moving through this field and are influencing the thoughts and emotions of all Earth humans. There are focal points on Earth where the cosmic energy is more amplified than on other points. On planet Earth, one of these places is located at Sedona in Arizona. Millions of years ago, this area in Arizona was underwater because it was the North Pole. What we see today in Sedona was once the bottom of the sea. In that times, there was an underwater crystal city in that area. After a pole shift, the water retreated and revealed these beautiful rock formations. Thousands of years later, there were again extraterrestrials living in this area and using the vortex energies. Today, there are many etheric crystal cities under Sedona, but they exist within the fifth and sixth density realities. Each rock in Sedona has a crystal inside. Due to the high concentration of iron, the rocks became red. The iron in the crystals under Sedona are amplifying the vortex energies. A vortex is a connection point where the energies of the spiritual dimensions are entering the physical dimension. Since today, many extraterrestrials are using the vortexes in Sedona like a stargate, an interdimensional portal. Especially on some rock formations where the energy is concentrated as a vortex. There are many dimension gates in Sedona. Some are on fixed points and some are appearing only for a short time. When you enter Sedona, you get in touch with fourth density vibration. The vortex energies in Sedona can speed up your spiritual growth and amplify your thoughts. They have a healing effect on the physical and spiritual body and the consciousness. As I said on my other videos, thoughts are energy and have an effect on our surroundings. In March and April 2011, I visited with 17 other lightworkers the vortex energies in Sedona. We went to all the vortex points and we used them to send love energy to the planet and to raise the consciousness of all Earth humans. In other words, to transform the negative energies on Earth into positive energies and create a loving planet. In addition, I gave all participants an energy boost to get easier in touch with the vortex energies. The energies of Sedona should be used only for spiritual purposes with a loving heart. Without a loving heart, the energy can harm you because you will face your own negativity. So before you visit vortex places, make sure to clean your aura and your thoughts. For that reason, I started the lightwork tour at a specific location at the River of Red Rock Crossing. It is a doorway for Pleiadian and Arcturian energy. After our love meditation, one of us took a picture of the love energy we have created with many orbs in it. Orbs are consciousness. They are light beings from other dimensions who are observing, learning and helping. You see them often at places with good energy or at a dimension gate. Here you can see how I attract orbs by using love energy. On energy places, you have to be careful what you are thinking and what emotions you have, because it will manifest quicker than on normal places. In that way, everybody learns to be more conscious about the energies he is creating. If you go to energy places or meet real light workers, the powerful light energy will reveal whatever is within you. Every energy you have inside will come to the surface. You will be forced to clean things in your life much faster. If you have love energy, you will feel more love energy and you can clean blocks easy. If you have suppressed negative emotions like hatred, arrogance, judgment, fear, envy, it will come to the surface too, so you can see what you have to work on. Our next visit was at Airport Vortex. At every vortex place you can see many twisted trees, because cosmic energy flows always in a spiral form. This vortex has Andromeda energy and it's good for emotional healing, especially at a medicine wheel. A medicine wheel is a marking and shows you where the energy is most powerful. It shows where two ley lines of the Earth join together and are forming a power spot. You can find many medicine wheels in Sedona. Some are a few years old and some are ancient. We use this pot for a powerful healing exercise. Snapply Hill Vortex is also a place for power and spirit. It can be used as a doorway for consciousness from the future. Don't forget that the energy of the vortexes are stored even in these recorded pictures, and they have an impact on you. Because everything is energy and everything is interconnected with energy. So focus on positive thoughts and emotions, and you will get the energy intensified back, so you can use it for your own spiritual development. A very special vortex energy can be found at the place called Cathedral Rock. By meditating here, you can gain wisdom energy. At the backside of the rock, you can find a small pyramid with another stone color than the main rock. At this place, the Pleiadians have placed a purple crystal inside the rock to help you to adjust to higher energies. At this picture, you can see a light beam from a spaceship showing me the place of the crystal. And in this picture, you can see the energy radiation of the crystal. So we sat down on the pyramid for meditation and absorbed the energy. Opposite of Cathedral Rock is a rock which is another dimension gate. We call this rock the ancient extraterrestrial ruins, because at the top of the rock you can find rectangular stones that look like the base of a temple. They look as if they had been cut with a laser millions of years ago. Some of these blocks have fallen down but did not crack. The energy up there is very powerful and it's giving you strength. So we did our light rock meditation here too. Bellrock is the most famous vortex in Sedona. Bellrock is a dynamo for cosmic energies. It is one of the main focal points of the electromagnetic grid around the Earth, which is connected with many power spots around the planet. That is why we did here light work too, sending love and light energies around the planet to neutralize any negative energy. We used my meditation from part 4 of my videos. Remember, thoughts and emotions are energy and are creating our future. Energy is information. At the Boynton Canyon Vortex under the rock called Kachina Woman, you can feel Sirian energy. The next day we went to an energy place called Shaman's Cave. In a cave you are surrounded by the crystals in the rock and you can get deeper in tune with the planet's energy. Here you can meditate in silence, since it's far away from the known Sedona places and only local people know how to get there. In this cave we chanted a mantra to stimulate the third eye and bring the body in a higher vibration. After that, we projected our high frequency to everybody on this planet. At the Native American ruins of Honanki, we connected with Indian spirits and together we created a powerful spiral energy for Earth cleansing. Here at Honanki, the energy is very good, and therefore one night I was able to film some spaceships and orbs. These lightships were only visible through my night vision camera because they were vibrating in another frequency.
Look.
Huh? Oh,
yeah. even more orbs are coming now. The energy is increasing. Just open your heart. Look at this. Look, it's coming closer. It's closer and moving. Disappeared.
Oh my God.
You see it? It was...
The next day we went to the West Fork Vortex. West Fork is a non-physical fifth density entry point for consciousness of the Sirius constellation. But of course you can use the vortex energy also for personal spiritual purposes. Right next to Chimney Rock is Thunder Mountain, Capitol Butte. Under Capitol Butte is an ET base and a Lemurian crystal city in a higher frequency. At this mountain you can find a huge cave where you can feel the energy of Lemurians and Native American spirits. During and after our love meditation, those spirits came as huge orbs. If you come with the right energy, the energy of love, you can get in touch with them and receive spiritual energy and wisdom. This energy and wisdom will unfold during your life at the right time. The next day we went to another cave at Long Canyon Vortex. At this cave, I gave personal healing sessions to the participants in cooperation with the spirits who are living at this place. At these sessions, I helped the participants to clean blockages and raise their frequency, so they can be ready for the higher frequencies that Earth wants to reach. In order to get into these higher spiritual frequencies smoothly and easy, all negative energies on Earth must be healed and transformed into loving energies. The planet will have to purify all these negative energies on his body to match with the higher frequencies. If he don't change his energies, the transformation can be very unpleasant, with hurricanes, floods, earthquakes and volcanic activity. Everybody on this planet is responsible of how the transformation will be. Only with love energy we can heal this planet, because with love you are in tune with the existence. Love is the solution for everything. The more people would send spiritual love energy to the planet, the more we can help others to raise their consciousness and stop them from harming the nature and humans. I encourage all loving humans to do light work for the planet now, to transform all negative energies on Earth into positive, lightful energies. If you do this on energy places, your energies can be more powerful and more effective. You will change your energy into a higher spiritual level, and you will be circulating and transforming energies and people around you. You will become a channel for love and cosmic light. You will become a lightful vortex.